Welcome to Growing Spaces. I'm Kyle. I'm a product specialist here at Growing Spaces. We're here to talk today about organic pest control. We're going to be investigating thrips today on some bean plants that we have in the 15. So here we are in the 15-foot growing dome. We came in the other day and noticed that the pole beans that we've planted actually are not doing so well. As you can see, there are a couple beans on there. Some of them have died, and there's basically no green left. All right, so if we take a look at this bean, you can see that there's just nothing left here. On some of these other bean plants where there's just a few brown leaves, we might go ahead and prune them. But this one in particular, we're just gonna go ahead and pull this out and just go along. These ones are severely infected. So at these beans here, there's just a few leaves that are really suffering. You can see some damage, some little spots on there from their feces. So I'm just gonna go ahead and prune these back a little. Any spent blossoms, it's a good idea to go ahead and prune these back as well, because thrips actually like to hang out inside of the blossom. It's a real good, cool, humid environment for the thrips to live. They're super small insects, so oftentimes, like we found in here, they're about 0.3 millimeters, so they're nearly microscopic. In identifying thrips, it's important to look for their cigar-shaped body. They are slender insects with fringed wings, so they're soft-bodied insects. They puncture the plant and suck the contents out, the phloem. Not all thrips are pests, because there are some thrips in here that we actually want to keep around because they're eating other pests around the greenhouse. So really, when we're managing the thrip population, we want to think about how we can control them, not necessarily eradicate them completely. One thing about thrips is that they are similar to spider mites. They do like really dry environments, so if you have a lack of water, you could potentially see an outbreak of thrips. So here we have a mixture of water and Dr. Bronner's. We went ahead and did the same ratio that we did for spider mites, which is 2 tablespoons per gallon. Neem oil is really good to add to the Dr. Bronner water mixture because the Dr. Bronner's acts as an emulsifier. It'll kind of help the neem oil stick a little better. And whenever I am spraying, I just go along and get the undersides of all the leaves. One thing to keep in mind with spraying is you gotta keep up on it. So I'll go ahead and do an initial dose today. It's Monday, and then probably come Wednesday, we'll do another dose of some spraying just because the population is pretty bad in here. Get some more beneficial mites and other predators going along in here. The life cycle of thrips, you have larval or pupal stage where the thrips live underground in the soil. And then they have the adult life where they live and feed on the plant. So this makes thrips really tricky in controlling because you might be able to control the adult population and then next thing you know, there's a whole another round of thrips that just were bred from the soil. Essentially, if you wanna really control the population, beneficials are the way to go. There are a few different methods of organic pest control that you can use. You can use a shop vacuum to vacuum them up if they're real concentrated in one particular area. There's a fungus spray available on the market. Go ahead and check out our blog for the details on all the sprays. You can blast them with a spray of water. There's also other beneficial insects. There we have it, organic pest control, how to deal with thrips. Check out our blog. Hey, thanks for watching. Please subscribe and have a good day.